we're trying to build robotic matter. That means materials, as we have seen them in the movies Terminator and Big Hero 6. Materials that can be programmed to change their shape and change their own material properties. So we're actually trying to solve three problems. The first is, of course, the sustainability aspect of it.
Yes, because materials make up an entire world. And to keep that up, we have to produce more and more matter. And if we can reuse the matter that we already have produced, we're not depleting nature's resources. We're actually using the same material building blocks again and again and again.
And the second point beyond sustainability is, of course, the economic aspect. Because if you only need one box of material at home, and out of that you can build your chair, and the next thing you can reuse it to build a jacket, then the whole economic process will change. And we actually make materials and tools and objects available to everywhere all the time. In a long-term future, of course, we can dream of other things we can do, novel functions that we cannot do today. Say, for example, that we can build exoskeletons out of this material that perfectly fit your own body, or that you even do reconstructive surgery using this technology, where you inject this type of artificial cells that we're going to build, and then they reconstruct, for example, a broken hip from the inside out. So you don't need open surgery, but it's reconstructed on the place. So we do this project in three steps. First, we make little particles, as you can see in the vial here, and we can control whether they stick or don't stick. In the next step, we make a blob of the material. That's what you can see on top of the red paper here. And we're now programming the shape of that blob. And after we program the shape, we feed it under the camera. The camera takes images. In that way, we create an image database that the machine algorithm can use to control the shape. In the last step, we will integrate magnetic particles and create a magnetic polymer. And doing that, we will be able to control the material properties of the material. The research question for us is actually split in three different parts. The first part is to build the microscale synthetic cells and how to bond and debond them again and again. The second question is how to form materials of which you can change the material properties from stiff to soft, and we do that by magnetic forces. So the third aspect that we do research on is to control the shape of the objects, and we do that by working together with the robotics people that help us to control the shape using machine learning.